Hello students, today we shall see application of matrices in connection with system of linear equations, their consistency and their solution by Gaussian elimination method and Gauss-Jordan method. So system of linear equations first. Consider the following m numbers of linear equations in n numbers of unknowns. Unknowns means variables x1, x2, x3, dot, 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 xn. So the system is a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus dot, 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 a1n xn equal to b1. This is first equation. Second equation is a21 x1 plus a22 x2 plus dot, 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 a2n xn equal to b2. And the mth equation is am1 x1 plus am2 x2 plus dot, 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 amn xn equal to bm, where this coefficients aij and bi, right side numbers bi, are constants, that is real numbers in our case. If at least one bi not equal to 0, b1 b2 bm, out of b1 b2 bm at least one of them is not 0, if one of them is not 0, then the system is said to be a non-homogeneous system of linear equations, non-homogeneous. And if all bi 0, b1 b2 bm all are 0, then the system is said to be a homogeneous system of linear equations. In matrix form, the above system of equations can be written as, see, just one bracket will be given here, this bracket and this bracket if we give, and with only one equality sign, then it will become in matrix form. Okay, so what we have given here, it is left side first bracket equal to right side first bracket. This is a matrix, this is a matrix, rather a column matrix, this is also a column matrix. Now this matrix can be obtained just by multiplying this coefficient matrix and this column vector. You can see a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus dot, 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 a1n xn, it is there. So product of this matrix and this column vector means column matrix equal to right side, and this can be written as ax equal to b, where A, capital A means this matrix Aij, m by n, m rows and n columns, and capital X means this variable vector, vector formed by variables x1, x2, xn, and capital B means right side vector, column vector b1, b2, bm. The matrix A, capital A in this case, is called the coefficient matrix or the associated matrix of the system of equations. It is associated with the system, coefficient matrix, matrix of coefficients, or associated matrix of the system of equations. Also the matrix notation is third bracket A colon B is what, nothing but A with an extra column b1 b2 dot, dot, bm means right side of the system of equations. This capital B is attached here, so the notation is this, and this matrix is called the augmented matrix of the system of equations. Augmented means attached, capital B is attached to the matrix A, and a new matrix obtained. This is called augmented matrix of the system of equations. It plays an important role. This matrix third bracket A colon B means augmented matrix is also written as, this symbol is, we can write just third bracket AB or third bracket A/B. These are also used as notation. The system of equations Ax equal to B in matrix form is said to be consistent or solvable. Consistent or solvable if it has a solution. That is, if there exists values of the unknowns x1, x2, dot, 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 xn, which satisfy all the equations of the system simultaneously. If the system has solution, it is not necessary that all system will have solution. Okay. So if the system has a solution, that is the unknowns or variables have values which satisfies all the equations of the system simultaneously, then the system is said to be consistent or solvable. You can solvable. Otherwise, the system is said to be inconsistent, that is if it has no solution. The homogeneous system Ax equal to O, or you can say Ax equal to 0, null vector, zero column vector, Ax equal to O is always consistent because X equal to O. X equal to O means null column vector, null vector. X capital X equal to O means actually all the variables x1, x2, x3, xn, all are zeros, all take values zeros, is clearly a solution, and it is called the trivial solution or zero solution. Trivial solution, obvious solution, or zero solution, and any other solution is called a non-trivial solution. If the system is homogeneous, means if all b1, b2, bm are 0, then if we put x1 0, x2 0, xn 0, see that all the equations will be satisfied if b1, b2, bm are all 0. Means homogeneous system is always consistent. It has 0 solution. That is known as trivial solution or 0 solution. But it may have also non-trivial solution, that is non-zero solutions. So, one standard theorem we are just stating. The necessary and sufficient condition for a non-homogeneous system of linear equations Ax equal to b in matrix form as given above to be consistent, that is to have a solution, is that rank A equal to rank of the augmented matrix. Rank of the coefficient matrix A is equal to rank of the augmented matrix third bracket A colon B. So this is necessary and this is sufficient condition for the system to have a solution. That is to be consistent. We are not proving it. We shall just apply the result. Nature of solution. Consider a system of m linear equations in n unknowns given by Ax equal to b in matrix form. If rank A, rank of the coefficient matrix A, not equal to rank of the augmented matrix A colon B, then the system is inconsistent. That is, the system has no solution. If rank A and rank A colon B are not equal, the system has no solution. Why no solution? Practically, we shall see in example. If rank A equal to rank of augmented matrix, rank of coefficient matrix is equal to rank of augmented matrix, third bracket A colon B is equal to N, suppose. What is N? The number of unknowns or number of variables. Then the system is consistent and has a unique solution. Unique solution. This is another condition, Roman 3, if rank A equal to rank of the augmented matrix equal to R and R is less than N, less than number of variables, it may happen, then the system is consistent and has infinite number of solutions. But only N minus R plus 1 of them are linearly independent, N minus R plus 1 of them, provided B not equal to O, means B not equal to null vectors, null column vectors. Then the system is non-homogeneous, and in that case N minus R plus 1 of them are linearly independent, although it has infinite number of solutions. And if B equal to O, means null vector, null column vector, homogeneous system, then the system Ax equal to O, system is Ax equal to O. Then in this case, it has N minus R linearly independent solutions. For non-homogeneous, number of linearly independent solutions is n minus r plus 1, where r is rank of the coefficient matrix, rank of the augmented matrix. And if the system is homogeneous, then it has n minus r linearly independent solutions. This n minus r also plays an important role. Okay. Now, solution of a system of n linear equations in n unknowns by matrix inversion method. That we have done in class 12 also, still it is discussed again here. Consider the following n linear equations in n unknowns. Here number of equations equal to number of variables. And in matrix form, Ax equal to b here. Of course, A will be a square matrix. A is Aij, n by n matrix, square matrix of order n, capital X is column vector of variables x1, x2, xn, b is b1, b2, bn. Let determinant of A not equal to 0, so that A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint A exists, that you know. If a matrix is square matrix is non-singular, it is inverse, given by this 1 by determinant of A into adjoint A, satisfying A inverse equal to A inverse A is equal to I. Therefore, A inverse AX equal to A inverse B means system is AX equal to B multiplied by A inverse from the left, and by associative property of multiplication, matrix multiplication, we can write A inverse AX equal to A inverse B, but A inverse A is I, IX is again X, so it is X equal to A inverse B, capital X equal to A inverse B, solution vector, which is the unique solution by matrix inversion method. Okay, now if determinant of A equal to 0, then the matrix inversion method fails. In that case, we shall apply Gaussian elimination method, we shall see later. Now, another note. If determinant of A is not 0, means non-singular A, then the solution is X equal to A inverse B. That is 1 by determinant of A into adjoint A into B. Now, capital X means the variable vectors, vector of the variables x1, x2, xn, column vector, and 1 by determinant of A, and adjoint A. Adjoint A means transpose of the matrix of cofactors. So, it is capital A11, capital A21, dot, 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 capital AN1. Then capital A12, capital A22, dot, 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 capital AN2, dot, dot, dot. And last row is A1N, A2N, ANN. Capital letters denote cofactors. And it is actually transpose of the cofactor matrix into this B1, B2, Bn, right side capital B. Now, if we multiply, we get this matrix multiplication. So, from this, X1 equal to this 1 by determinant of A into first row, first element, then x2 will be with 1 by determinant of A into second element, etc. So in general, we write xi. Xi equal to 1 by determinant of A into ith row here, b1 a1i plus b2 a2i plus dot 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 bn ani. And this expression let us denote by determinant of ai. Determinant of ai. So xi is determinant of ai by determinant of A. What is determinant of ai? Determinant of ai here is actually, it is the determinant of the coefficient matrix A with its ith column replaced by B. Ith column replaced by B. Because the multipliers are here B1, B2, Bn. As if the determinant is expanded in terms of ith column. Okay. Element, sum of the product of the elements of a column with corresponding cofactors gives the value of the determinant that we know. Property of determinant. Sum of the product of the elements of a column with corresponding cofactors is the value of the determinant. So that's why determinant of Ai is the nothing but determinant of the coefficient matrix A with its ith column replaced by B. And this is known as Cramer's rule. This solution, we get x1, x2, xn, etc. This is Cramer's rule. Okay. Now, main method, Gaussian elimination method. In this method, the given system of m linear equations in n unknowns is first written in matrix form. And then applying elementary row operations only, the coefficient matrix is reduced to echelon form and the ranks of the coefficient matrix and augmented matrix are obtained. And if they are equal, that is if the system is consistent, then the system is again written in individual equations form and then the unknowns are obtained by back substitution. Back substitution means last variable will be obtained first. You will see in the example. This method is general and can be applied when the number of equations and the number of unknowns are unequal. If equal, then also can be applied. Unequal or equal. Okay. And also can be applied when matrix inversion method or Cramer's rule fails. Matrix inversion method or Cramer's rule fails, then we can apply Gaussian elimination method. This is general method. Here we have written, first we read the system in matrix form and then applying elementary row operations to the system itself. The coefficient matrix is reduced to echelon form and attaching the right side with the coefficient matrix, we can check whether rank of the augmented matrix is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix or not, etc. Or directly we can use, of course, augmented matrix. We shall see in example. Okay, so this is Gaussian elimination method. Another method is Gauss-Jordan method of solving a system of n linear equations in n unknowns. Here, number of equations should be equal to number of unknowns. Gauss-Jordan method. Okay, in this method of solving a system of n linear equations in n unknowns, the system is first written in matrix from Ax equal to B. And then, using elementary row operations only, the augmented matrix third bracket echelon B is converted to echelon form, and if consistent, then A is converted to a diagonal matrix or a unit matrix specially, and then the unknowns are readily obtained. No further calculation will be necessary, but the steps will be more. Gaussian elimination method is easier. Gauss-Jordan method takes more time, and of course, in this case, extra operations to be applied, we shall see in example in the next class. Today we shall see Gauss-Jordan method on a Gaussian elimination method only. Okay, so let us see first example. Test consistency of the following system of linear equations and solve it if consistent. So three systems given. Let us solve number one. In matrix form, the system is, see, the coefficients are 3, minus 1, 1. First, then 1 minus 1, 4, then 2, 5, 1. These are written here, and x, y, z, variables x, y, z. Ax equal to b, right side is 5, 6 minus 2. So ax equal to b, say. The system is given in standard form, x, y, z, x, y, z, x, y, z. If any constants is given to the left side, you have to set change and keep the system in standard form. X, y, z, and right side, the constant terms you have to keep. So, in matrix form, we have written the system, Ax equal to B, say. Now, here in this system, you can directly apply eliminatory row operations, or you can consider the augmented matrix. So, let us consider better augmented matrix. The augmented matrix of the system is this capital A, and this 5, 6, minus 2 is attached as a fourth column, C. So, this is augmented matrix. Now, let us convert this augmented matrix to echelon form. So, for converting to echelon form, if this first element, is 1, then it is better. If this first element is 1, it is better to make rest 0. So that's why what we do, we interchange first and second row. And one thing we should note, that in solving system of equations, we have to apply only row operations, not column operations. See, row operations only. In the theory, it is written row operations only. Why? Because in solving a system of linear equations, from class 8 also, you know what we do. We eliminate variables by subtracting one equation from the other, or multiplying one equation with some constant and then subtracting it from other. In that case, what do? We operate row-wise, not column-wise. You see, coefficient of x is 3 and coefficient of y is minus 1. These 3 and minus 1 cannot be added, because this is x, this is y, cannot be added. But this 3x and this x, if we add the two equations, then 3x plus x, 4x, means coefficients can be added, can be subtracted like that. So only row operations, no column operation allowed in solving system of linear equations. Okay, so this first or second row interchanged, so we have brought this one in the first position. Now let us make this 3 and 2 0 using this one. How? Second row minus 3 times first row, third row minus 2 times first row. So we have written here R2 changed to R2 minus 3 1, R3 changed to R3 minus 2 R1. Okay. Now accordingly other elements changed. So 3 times subtracted means minus 1 plus 3 means 2, 1 minus 12 means minus 11, 5 minus 18 means minus 13, and here 2 times subtracted means 2 minus 2 0, 5 minus plus 2. So minus plus 2 7, 1 minus 8 means minus 7, minus 2 minus 12 means minus 14. Okay, got. Now this is not in echelon form. Our aim is to make this element 0, this element. Our aim is to make this element, sorry, this element 0. To make it 0, what we do, we see that minus 7, minus 7, minus 14 there. So it can divide this row by 7 and make this element 1. It will be better. So what we have done, R3 changed to 1 by R3. So 1 by 7, R3. This is not R2. This should be R3. 1 by 7, R3. So that it becomes 1, minus 1, minus 2. And after that, and then R3 and R2 interchanged. So two operations we have done. We have divided third row by 7, and then we have interchanged third row, means new third row and old second row. So we have got it. So that 1 comes here, and easily we can make this element 0 now. Okay. So now new R3 changed to R3 minus 2 R2. This is not R2. This should be R3. Okay. R3 minus 2 R2. So what you get? 2 minus 2 0, minus 11, minus minus plus, it will be plus 2 means minus 9, minus 13 plus 4, minus 13 plus 4, 2 times subtracted, so it will be plus 4 means 9, minus 9. Now we see that this is in echelon form. Number of zeros increased from first row to second row 1 0, from second row to third row 2 0, so increasing trend before first non-zero entry. So which is in echelon form? With 3 non-zero rows, this matrix, third order echelon, be reduced to, converted to echelon form with 3 non-zero rows for both A and echelon B. You see, if I omit this row, then this is our, this column, then this is our A. So for A, non-zero rows is 3, and if I attach this, then also non-zero rows is 3. So for both A and A, we have three non-zero rows in echelon form. Therefore, rank of the augmented matrix is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix is equal to 3, but equal to number of unknowns. It is equal to number of unknowns. There are three variables. Therefore, the system is consistent and has a unique solution. Only one solution, one set of solution rather. Okay, how we can see. Now, the equivalent system is the system coefficient matrix changed, right side also changed. So equivalent system is, this is now new A, this is new B. Here one symbol we have used, wiggle. It is not equal. This matrix when applied, this operation is equivalent to this, not equal. That's why this symbol is given equivalent. So the equivalent system is, first here coefficient 1 means 1x minus y plus 4z equal to 6. Then 0x plus 1y minus 1z equal to minus 2. See, it is written y minus z equal to minus 2. And last one is 0x 0y minus 9z equal to minus 9. Minus 9z equal to minus 9 written. So from third one we get z equal to 1. See that last variable coming first. That, and then value of z will be substituted in number 2. And then value of y and z will be substituted in number 1. Means we get the variables from the back side. That's why in the theory it was written, the, by back substitution we get the solution. So from 3, we have got z equal to 1, and then putting the value of z in number 2, we get y equal to z minus 2 means 1 minus 2 minus 1, and then putting the value of y and z in number 1, we get x equal to y minus 4 z plus 6 means minus 1 plus minus 4, z is 1 plus 6 so 1. Therefore, solution is x equal to 1, y equal to minus 1, z equal to 1. So this is unique solution you have got. Okay. Now, number 2. System number 2 we have to solve. See that in system number 2, what you notice, the third equation has coefficient 1 for x. Coefficient of x is 1. So if it is in the first position, it will be easier. If we change the order of equation, the system does not change. Okay, so we can consider third equation as first equation, so that one step we may omit in converting to echelon form. So that I have considered here. Considering third equation as first equation, the system is, third one I have taken written first. Okay, the system is this. In matrix form, the system is Ax equal to B. Ax equal to B, say. What is A? A here, 1, minus 3, minus 8, first row, 2, 5, 6, second row, 3, 1, minus 4, third row, and capital X means here, X, Y, Z variable vector, and minus 10, 13, 0. Okay, now we convert these to, here, instead of considering augmented matrix, we can apply the elementary row operations to the system itself. This is another process I am writing. Whichever you feel easier, you will do. So, instead of considering augmented matrix in the full system, we are considering, we are applying elementary row operations. Our aim is to convert the coefficient matrix A to echelon form. Automatically, echelon B will be converted to echelon form. Okay. So, here already one is there. Because we have written third equation as first equation, so one step we have omitted technically. Now R2 minus 2R1 and R3 minus 3R1 will make these two elements 0. So we have operated this. So we have got 1, 0, 0 here, and then 5 minus minus 6 means plus 11, 6 minus minus 16, 22, and 3 times subtracted from third row, 1 minus minus 9 means 10, minus 4 minus minus plus 24 means 20. And similar operations we have done here also, 13 minus 2 times this 10 means minus minus plus, so it will be 33, and 0 minus 2 times of minus 10 means 20. Sorry, 3 times it is 30. Okay, so now second row we can divide by 11, no fraction coming, so that's why we have divided by 11. R2 changed to 1 by 11 R2, and third row we have divided by 10, easily we can divide, no fraction coming. Generally we avoid fractional operation, but here fraction is not coming in the answer, that's why. So R3 changed to 1 by 10 R3, nice values we have got. Now if we, this is not in echelon form, we want to make this element 0 so that it will be in echelon form. Therefore R3 minus R2, obvious operation. So incidentally both the elements become 0. So right side also accordingly we have changed. So this is A, this is A. Now if we attach this column here, then it will be echelon B. So from this also we can say that what is rank of A, what is rank of A colon B. Okay, so what do we say? Clearly A and A colon B. This A, and if we attach this here, it will be A colon B, means augmented matrix are now in echelon form with two non-zero rows. For A it is two non-zero rows. If we attach this B here, then also it is zero, so non-zero rows, number of non-zero rows is two. Therefore rank of augmented matrix and rank of A coefficient matrix are same, both are same, equal to two, but it is less than number of unknowns because there are three unknowns, x, y, z, three variables. Therefore the system is consistent. Theory says that yes, the system is consistent and has infinitely many solutions. Infinitely many solutions, but only n minus r plus 1 of them are linearly independent. N minus r plus 1 of them, n means number of variables, r means rank of the coefficient matrix A, here rank of the augmented matrix, so 2 plus 1, because the system is non-homogeneous. So and finally we are getting n minus r plus 1 is 2, means two numbers of linearly independent solutions. Although it has infinitely many solutions, but only two of them are linearly independent. Okay, now you can see why rank A and rank A colon B are to be equal for consistency. Suppose this element is not 0. Suppose this is not 0. Okay, suppose it is 2. Then the third equation becomes what? 0x plus 0y plus 0z equal to 2. Means 0 equal to 2. Totally absurd. Means last equation becomes 0 equal to 2. Absurd situation. That's why rank A and rank A colon B should be equal for consistency. If it is not 2, if it is 0 as we have got here, then no problem. 0x plus 0y plus 0z equal to 0, 0 equal to 0. So that is why coefficient matrix and augmented matrix should have same rank. Okay, for consistency. And how? Infinite number of solutions, let us see. The reduced equivalent system. Why reduced? Because this third equation is out. Already we were given three equations, but one is redundant, means one equation can be removed, duplicate equation. From the two equations you can find the third equation like that. So third equation removed, so number of equations decreased. That's why we have written reduced equivalent system is. So what is the reduced system? 1x minus 3y minus 8z equal to minus 10, first equation. Second equation, 0x plus 1y plus 2z equal to 3. So we have written here y plus 2z equal to 3, number 2, two equations. Now we have to solve this. So from third one, second one, we get y equal to 3 minus 2z. Z is here free variable. We cannot find z. Z can take any value. So we are keeping z free and then putting the value of y in number 1, we get x equal to 3y plus 8z minus 10, means 2z minus 1, finally putting this value of y. So solution, see, x is in terms of z, y is also in terms of z, and z is free, z can take any value. Therefore solution is given by x equal to, we have written 2k minus 1, it was 2z minus 1, we have written 2k minus 1. Y is 3 minus 2z, we have written 3 minus 2k. And what is z? Z equal to k. What is k? K is any real number, you can put anything to k. So this will satisfy the system. You can check putting these values of x, y, z in original equations, you will see that the equations are satisfied. So the system has infinite number of solutions because k is arbitrary, k can take infinite number of values. But as mentioned, this has only two linearly independent solutions. Let us see this as a note. Now taking k equal to 0 and 1, specially simple values, k equal to 0 if I take and k equal to 1 if I take, then the two solution vectors we shall get, values of x, y, z will constitute a vector when written as a column. So let us name it capital X1. When k is 0, minus 1, 3 and 0. And when k is 1, it is 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 2, 1 and z is 1. So 1, 1, 1. So these are two linearly independent solutions. It is easily seen that they are linearly independent because one of them is not a multiple of the other. Because for X1, third component is 0 and for X2, third component is 1. We cannot express X2 as a linear combination of X1 or as a scalar multiple of X1 or X1 as a scalar multiple of X2. So they are linearly independent. Still, by formal justification we can show like that, justification of the fact that x1 and x2 are li. If it is x, so they are li. So let alpha 1 x1 plus alpha 2 x2 0. 0 means 0 vector here, where alpha 1 alpha 2 are scalars, means real numbers. Then putting the values of x1 and x2 and multiplying and adding, we get this 0. Therefore component wise they are equal, so minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2 0, 3 alpha 1 plus alpha 2 0, alpha 2 equal to 0. So last one, alpha 2 0, if I put here alpha 2 0, alpha 1 is also 0, so ultimately we get In first one also, if I put alpha to 0, you get alpha 1 0. So alpha 1 0 and alpha 2 0 means both the coefficients are 0. Linear combination 0, both the coefficients are 0. Scalar coefficients are 0. That means what? This is the definition of linear independence. Therefore, x1 and x2 are li, linearly independent. Okay, so directly we have shown, and as already I have told, it is written here also. Alternatively, clearly x1 and x2 are such that one is not a scalar multiple of the other, so they are linearly independent. You can say like that for two vectors, of course, not for three, for two. We know that two vectors are linearly dependent if and only if one is a scalar multiple of the other, because if v1 and v2 are two vectors in Rn space, means Euclidean n space, then they are LD if and only if there exist two scalars alpha 1 and alpha 2 not both 0, such that alpha 1 b1 plus alpha 2 b2 0. This is the definition. Now if alpha 2 not 0, suppose, then b2 equal to minus alpha 2 inverse alpha 1 b1. Okay, just side change and multiply by alpha 2 inverse, you get, means b2 equal to lambda b1. I can take minus alpha 2 inverse alpha 1 as scalar lambda. So b2 is a scalar multiple of b1, where lambda is this. Or you can, if alpha 1 not 0, you can express b1 as a scalar multiple of b2 also. So for two vectors, it is easy to check. Okay. Then system number 3, solution of equation, system number 3. In matrix form, the given system of equations is, see system number 3 here. This is important. For number 1, number of variables equal to number of equations. For number 2 also, number of variables equal to number of variables. But for 3, number of variables is 3 but number of equations 4, and here we are bound to apply Gaussian elimination method. Okay, so the system in matrix form we have written first, Ax equal to b as before. Okay, all the coefficients written, x, x, y, z, and b means I said 3, 1, 2, minus 1. So 3 variables, 4 equations. Here we cannot think of Cramer's rule or matrix inversion method. Gaussian elimination method only. So in this case also, as in Ruman 2, I have done applied the elementary operations in the system. In Ruman 1, I have taken augmented matrix. Here also, let us take augmented matrix. Okay. So if I consider augmented matrix, this 3, 1, 2, minus 1 means right side B will be attached here. And this is our augmented matrix. Third vector A colon B notation. Now we want to reduce it to echelon form. So first element is 1, element in the first column is 1, so better. So multiply first row by 3, subtract from second row, multiply first row by 2, subtract from third row, and directly subtract first row from third row. So these operations are mentioned here, R2 minus 3R1, R3 minus 2R1, R4 minus R1. So after operation, we have got this, and this you may check later. Okay. Now this is not in echelon form. Now we want to make this echelon form. So this is our leading element. Now this element is important. With this minus 7, we have to make this to 0, but fractional operation we try to avoid. That's why we want to make this minus 7 as 1. So for that, what we have done, R2 row 2 second row minus 2 times row 4. Okay, 2 times row 4 means 6, minus 7, minus minus, plus 6, it will be minus 1. So 1 or minus 1 will do the same purpose, easier. Okay, so we have made it minus 1, R2 minus 2 R4, and another operation we have done, R3 minus 2 R4, so that this minus 6 becomes 0. Okay, so we have got this, and then this minus 3 now we want to make 0. It is already 0, so we this want to make this minus 3 0, so that it will be in echelon form. So R4 minus 3 times R2. Okay, we are getting 0, and here getting minus 4 minus 4. Okay, so this is not in echelon form, because this element again we have to make 0. These two elements, okay, 3 minus 3, we have made 0. Now these two is there, because 1 and 2, number of zeros not increased from third row to fourth row. So we have to make this minus 4 zeros. So another operation, because already 1 is there. So fourth row minus 4, sorry, fourth row plus 4 times third row. So this will become 0. Therefore, we have made this operation. So 12 and minus 4, 16 and minus 4 with 12 we are getting. So, okay. See, zeros are in increasing trend. From first row to second row, 1 0, second row to third row, 2 0, so third row to fourth row, 3 0s. Just 1 by 1 0. This 0 we shall not count. zero number of zeros preceding first non-zero entry, increasing trend. So it is in echelon form, which is in echelon form with three non-zero rows for capital A. See, if this is our A, up to this, if I consider this is A, so for A, three non-zero rows. But if I consider A colon B, means this column is attached, this column is attached, then fourth row is also non-zero. So three non-zero rows for A and four non-zero rows for augmented matrix A colon B. Therefore, rank A equal to rank A equal to 3, but not equal to rank A colon B, because rank A colon B means rank of the augmented matrix is 4. Fourth row is also non-zero for augmented matrix. Therefore, rank A not equal to rank of the augmented matrix. That means what? The system is inconsistent. That is, it has no solution. So every system may not have solution. Any linear system written, if it is asked, first we have to check whether it is consistent or not. You can see the practicability here also. See, the third equation, as I have told in previous example also, fourth equation becomes what? 0 into x plus 0 into y plus 0 into z equal to 12. So fourth equation becomes 0 equal to 12. Absurd. Total absurd. That's why this system is inconsistent. That means our rank test is good test. Rank A not equal to rank A colon B. Rank of quotient matrix not equal to rank of augmented matrix means the system is inconsistent, because we are getting an absurd situation on operating some operating using operations, elementary operations to the given equations. Okay, so up to this, today we stop here, and in the next lecture also some more examples shall be done, and Gauss-Jordan method shall be also applied to solve this system. Thank you for today.